What does Jesus do in response to these misguided expectations? Jesus does something that none of them would have expected. He got up from the table, took off his robe, wrapped a towel around his waist, and poured out water into a basin. Then he began to wash the disciples' feet, drying them with the towel he had around him. Why would Jesus choose to do this in this last moment? Out of all the things he could be doing, why would he be doing this? Because if we know a hard thing is coming, most of us would be trying to relax, trying to de-stress. So why would Jesus do this? He wanted them to understand, if you're going to call yourselves my disciples, you have to reflect my lifestyle. I didn't come to be served, but instead I came to serve. Let's go back to the original question of our entire series. What was I made for? Often the tendency when we bump up against that question is to try to answer it exclusively focused on ourselves. Like the greatest destination we could reach is our own pleasure. As if the pinnacle of achievement for us would be to experience forgiveness and then being set free, and then to discover what you love and then live out loving what you do. That seems like, if we're short-sighted, that seems like the ultimate goal. But in this moment, Jesus redefines the destination for our focus in life. He wasn't just redefining for his disciples what he came to do. Instead, he's redefining for us how we ought to live. So what's the point? What is the destination? It's not just to know God. It's not just to experience freedom from our past. It's not just to discover how God has wired us to discover the purpose he's created us for. But even beyond that, God wants you to make a difference for someone else.